Hi there. My prediction today is about the development within gene editing. We have already witnessed a lot of breakthroughs in this area. In 2003, we experienced the first mapping of the human genome, which was a tremendous achievement. And then in 2013, just 10 years later, we saw the invention of a technique called CRISPR-Cas, which is a fairly simple and low-cost methodology to alter any gene in any organism. And from that point on, things have gone pretty ballistic. We now stand with a technology that potentially can eradicate most genetic diseases, but it also allows us to change a whole animal race or to alter an embryo in order to decide the sex or to increase the probability of things like, for example, blue eyes. And in 2019, we saw the birth of the first two gene-edited twin girls in Shenzhen in China. That was broadly condemned afterwards, but it just shows what is possible today. And we are now seeing the first FDA-approved treatments for genetic diseases. Luxturna from Spark Therapeutics is one example. They treat a specific type of inherited retinal dystrophy, which basically means that you lose your ability to see, but a treatment costs $850,000 per patient. Zolgensma from Novartis is another one. It promised to treat something called spinal muscular atrophy, which is also a rare genetic disease. They do that with just one injection, but it cost $2.1 million. And of course, this have led to a heavy discussion about pricing and benefit, because how can you put a price tag on life? And while this discussion is heating up, we see new and interesting techniques being developed. If CRISPR-Cas works like a scissor and a pencil, then a new technique called prime editing works more like a word processor, which basically means that you can now do virtually any alteration: add, delete, swap single genes in a DNA, and without actually harming the DNA double helix. Gene drive is another genetic engineering technology that can force a particular suite of genes throughout a population. This brings promise to, for example, eradicate malaria-transmitting mosquitoes, but of course it also bears the risk of a lot of unintended consequences. So naturally, this leaves us with a lot of deep ethical discussions, like which chances are we willing to take, who should be allowed to perform these alterations, and in which situations. And meanwhile, you can now log on to a website called theodin.com and buy your own beginner's CRISPR kit for just $159, which a lot of nerds have done. And this have led to communities of so-called biohackers around the world. So it is a technology that is hard to contain within certain boundaries. I predict several major commercial breakthroughs within gene editing in 2020. But at the same time, I also expect a heated debate about the ethical aspects of this technology. If you want to dig deeper into this topic, I strongly recommend the Netflix documentary series called On Natural Selection, which was published in October 2019. So CRISPR and gene editing is a technology area that will develop in 2020. Look out for that.